हाय फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल फिजिक्स गुना। सो मेरे का सब्सक्राइब चाहिए ना, इमीडिएट सब्सक्राइब चाहिए। सो टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज इंपॉर्टेंट डेफिनेशंस इन ऑप्टिक्स, सी पी आर एफ एफ यू एंड वी। व्हाट आर दोस? दिस आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट। ओके, विद इन फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकंड्स आई वुड लाइक टू एक्सप्लेन दिस। टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस वन वी हैव टू टेक ए स्फीयर, दैट मींस द स्फीयर इज इन ए स्फेरिकल शेप। From that spherical shape, suppose if you take any arc, that means like this. This is called as a curved surface. This is called as curved surface. Based on the reflecting area, the curved surfaces we have divided into two parts. One is convex and another one is concave. For example, if this area is reflecting, that means if the bulged surface is reflecting the light, then we can call that one as a convex mirror. Suppose if inside one is reflecting the light, then that is called as concave. Just a small example I would like to express you, that is how we can be remember this concave. So it's very simple, my dear friends. That is, suppose if you take a curved surface, this is a curved surface, this is reflecting area, that means it is available to go inside, that means only for the caves we are enter. That means whatever the reflecting surface is inside or inwards, okay, then it is called as a concave. It is called as a concave. Suppose if we remember one, we can easily understand, or we can easily remember another one. That means it is not allowing the light, it is a silver coated area, that means this area only reflecting the light, that is called as a concave mirror. So if the bulged surface is reflecting the area, then that is called as convex mirror. After that, we have to discuss about the center of curvature. What that means, C. What is C stands for? C stands for center of curvature. So center of curvature means how we have obtained the spherical mirror from the sphere or not. Yes, definitely. So this is a total sphere. From that sphere, we have taken a small part. So this is a part. So for this spherical surface, that means From which sphere we are taking? Okay, for this sphere we are taking, the center of the sphere we are calling as a center of the curvature. That one we are denoting with the letter C. Okay, from which sphere we are taking that sphere, that is called as spherical center of curvature. After that, we have to be discuss about the radius of curvature. So the radius of curvature. Before that, I would like to explain the P. P stands for pole. P means pole. So what is pole? What is pole means, it is a geometrical surface area. From the geometrical surface area, the center of the geometrical surface area, we are calling as a pole. Okay. Then the line joining, this is the line we are joining between the center of curvature and the pole, is called as principal axis. That means this axis is we are calling as a principal axis. This one is called as a principal axis. Okay, what is radius of R stands for? Radius of curvature. Radius of curvature means the distance between the center of curvature, that means C, and the pole. This is called as radius of curvature. That one we are denoting with the letter R. After that, focal point. Yes, what is focal point? Suppose if the rays are traveling from a very long distances, that means parallel rays. Okay, they are coming from the sun. Okay, from the sun, the rays are traveling very long distances, automatically they will become like a parallel. Suppose if you take this one as a concave mirror. So this ray is parallel to the principal axis. After this one, after reflection, it will goes like this. After reflection. So same like that, if you take one another ray, so this is incident ray, and this incident ray is after reflection, it is traveling like this. At a point, the parallel rays are intersecting one point, that point we are calling as a focus or focal point. Okay, where the reflected parallel rays after the reflection, where they are intersecting, that is called as focal point. What is F? Focal length. Length means distance from where to where. So from the pole to the focus, which is called as focal length. Suppose if you observe here, the relation between the R and F is R equals to 2F. That means F equals to R by 2. This is the relation between the radius of curvature and also the focal length. Okay, then what is U and what is V? What is U and what is V? To know that one, just you have to take a one object. You have kept that one beyond the sea. So from that, the rays are coming. The distance from the object to the pole. That means here. This one we are calling as a, that means up to here. This one we are calling as a object distance. You should not get confused. First we are keeping the object. That's why the object distance U. In our alphabets also the first letter is U. While we are doing the problems, we may get the doubt. Which one we have to be take as a object distance, which one we have to be take as a image distance. No need to get confused. First we are, because of we are keeping the object, we are getting the image. That's why the object distance is U. So the rays are coming like this. Suppose if they are intersecting it anywhere at some distance. Suppose if we observe the image here. So that means at that position, the distance between the optic center to the, that means pole to the, this one, that is image, is called as image distance. The distance between the pole to the image is called as V. That means image distance. So these are the basic points we should be remember. Suppose if we obtain the image on a screen, that is called as real image. Suppose if you are not able to obtain the image on any screen, that is called as a virtual image. Okay, so these are the main points. Suppose if you like this, so give you one like and share, subscribe, and for more notifications, click the bell icon. Thank you.